Hi, I'm Chris Jojo. I'm a senior sound designer and the principal car sound recording engineer at Codemasters EA Southam Studios in Warwickshire. We're here today at BGM Motorsport in Brackley, Northamptonshire. And we've just come off the back of a recording session at Millbrook on the Mile Straight Circuit. We were recording an RS200 Group B rally car. So we've got the new Gen 2017 today, so we just gave that a bit of a road test. So on the Mile Straight Circuit, around the half mile marker, so we got some fantastic pass-bys from that today. And again, higher SPL handling and fantastic tracking. So as the car's going all the way up to the banked apex, it's a bit like a NASCAR circuit. So we've got basically a mile of grade A tarmac. It's like autobahn level tarmac. So that's where all the action goes. So the cars are just going full pelt up to the limiter. And obviously they're going to do a couple if they can slot in a couple of runs in terms of the onload and the offload decel sweeps. So that the tracking on that mic's fantastic. It's one of the best shotguns I've used over the years. And again, the depth, it's a short throw, but again, the tracking's pretty decent. And when you're doing pass-bys and a car's receding into the distance and you get that fabulous, sort of all the reflections in the environment, if you're on a pit straight or you're in a forest, because it's fantastic at just isolating that sound. And then obviously as it recedes into the distance, you have this, the little depths and the overrun stuff there triggering. I think I became aware of DPA microphones probably back in the sort of late 90s, because I was aware of the microphones being used for F1 broadcasting. They were obviously still are. And I'd read some case studies online. I was always aware of DPA as being one of the top tier manufacturers of microphones, but I think it was specifically for their application for high SPL recording, not just for motorsports. I know quite a few recorders who specialise in firearms recording, and obviously guys like Watson Wu, he has quite a few DPAs in his loadout. So the idea is to obviously record the car on board, on track, and externally as well in respect of pass-bys. We'll have microphones over the exhaust, microphones in engine, again, placed specifically over, say, the cylinders to capture the induction again, whatever it may be, so that when you do hear that car, you'll be hearing it as authentically as possible. So for this particular session with the RS200, on the exhaust, we've got one 4007. Over the inline four cylinders, we've got another 4007. On the wastegate, we've got a 4011 focused directly on that. And we've got a 4062 on the gearbox. That's just for picking up the transmission. Just behind the central, behind the driver in the co-driver seat, we've got a 4007, and that just captures everything within that tiny little cabin space. So it's a cracking little mic for that. Important thing is with the exhaust is to get a certain degree of, well, it's obviously an off-axis position, but I use bespoke mounts to get the exhaust away from the bodywork, so we're getting a more natural sound, no wave reflections, and you need space between the microphone and the source just for it to breathe, but also for safety reasons, but to get that sweet spot, it's imperative to get an off-axis, a couple of feet away from the exhaust, and also to divert the wind from the capsules, the exhaust mics. And then we'll do a specific run for the transmission, which is very important now. So in this instance with the RS200, we were actually able to get inside the gearbox in front of the car where the gearbox and the front diff is, We had the drive shaft on the left, and we had a 4062 just tucked in the corner there. But we're getting those screaming harmonics from the straight cut gears. But because we're going to such enclosed spaces with lavalier microphones or the larger capsules with the dedicate pad modular cabling, it's critical to make sure that they're fireproofed, windproofed, and that it's not too bulky. But my first, you know, my first choice would always be the larger diaphragm, the dedicate system of pad modular cabling. So it would be for focused applications, say if it was like for a turbo blow-off valve or something that you just wanted to capture, like a supercharger, I'd use the cardioid 4011, and you get a beautiful, it's a flat response, but a fantastic off-axis response, which is critical because you can't, obviously with the heat source of an exhaust, you're always off-axis, but I'm close to it. I've got a little bit of air between the microphone and the exhaust, and because the microphones are so close together, like I say, if it's like three microphones or two, we're not going to have any issues with phase. You know, if you use too much in the way of focus miking, you're not getting that natural ambience. It's like recording a drum kit with the overheads are kind of like the foundation, or you'll have, you know, some stereo, you know, microphones just to capture that sense of the room. We did some recording for F1 for at an impact. There's one that, so it was like an F1 carbon fiber nose section on a sled, literally driving into a, you know, a barrier just to see what the split was like, what the tolerance was like. And if you record close mic up to that, you just get a crack and that's it. But then you record from a distance, you get the sound of the reflections of the room and the environment, and then it sells the sound. It just sounds more naturalistic, and it's the sound bedding within the environment.